here we go. Toronto millennials may dream of having their own backyard someday. Remember backyards? But in reality, they're stuck renting instead. And as stats and sales have shown, more and more millennials are having to forego the big lot and backyard and enter into bidding wars for rental properties.
Joining us now is real estate agent Jonathan Orlando with his tips and survival guide for millennials in the Toronto / GTA rental market.
Let's
and it's not
about
easy
it.
Anywhere, is it, Jonathan?
No.
Thank you very
no,
much
good
for
morning.
Joining us.
Good morning.
You are a millennial, so this is great because you have the experience as a broker and going in as, you know, millennial mindset.
Right.
Talk to us about the statistics. We are shocked to hear the average rental price for a one-bedroom apartment is
$2,160.
Impossible.
Yeah, according to Tripp, it's $2,160 for a one-bedroom. For a two-bedroom, $2,800.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow. And that is that across Toronto or in the
That's for the city of Toronto.
So in the old city of Toronto.
Yes, it is.
So in terms of, we were saying earlier, inventory in Mississauga versus Toronto, how is that differing right now?
Actually, Mississauga has a lower vacancy rate than Toronto does.
Why?
Because I think people are just tired of paying for Toronto pricing. They want to get the parking spot. They want to have the backyard. They want to have the opportunity to have more money to live their life rather than paying it all to rent.
All into rent. So what can you do? I mean, if you want to try and live in Toronto, what are some tips for millennials looking to find a place here in the city?
One thing I'm a big enthusiast of is always finding a roommate. Obviously, splitting $2,800 is a lot easier than carrying $2,200 on your own. Or I always say, find a boyfriend or a girlfriend and split that one bedroom. That's probably the cheapest alternative.
So what do they do going in? Because we also hear that that bubble is bursting. Does that mean now might be the time to buy? How do you know if you're equipped to buy?
Well, you got to, I always say, you always have to talk to a mortgage broker. Always, that's the first step. But, you know, it is the time to buy right now, I would say, because we are experiencing a little cooling, not necessarily cheaper, but we're not seeing those bidding wars where you have 20 people putting an offer on one property.
So it gives you some time to think.
Just a little bit.
And going in, you should be lined up, like find out what your max is, where you can go, and stick to it, right?
Yes.
And there's also a problem in terms of housing being available, because I was reading a stat that something as late as 2040 is when those homes will be available by the current boomers. Is that
right?
Yeah,
I read that. It was the 2040 was when baby boomers are going to start selling their homes and downsizing. So, and within the meantime, it's like 700,000 millennials are moving out within the next 10 years. So if you can imagine, that pushes down the supply and increases the demand drastically.
Well, I remember there was a time everyone's like, why are all these condos going up? They're half empty, but that's not the case anymore. They are being filled.
Everything's pretty full right now.
Everything's pretty full, and I think the city has also imposed a vacancy tax, so if no one's living there, the homeowner is liable to pay a tax on that.
And when you're looking for, are there things you can do when you're looking for a rental place that can make you look even better in the eyes of the landlord?
Well, I mean, you can make a lot of money, for one, have a great credit score. I mean, when you start this journey, it is very quick. You don't really have time to think about what your next place is going to look like. So I always suggest people always have their credit score, employment letters, and pay stubs ready to go, because sometimes you might even get a chance to see the place before it's off the market.
Mm-hmm. And what happened in April that is actually helping renters?
Well, the government's imposed a new form, which makes my job a little bit more difficult, but it's a form that pretty much reiterates the agreement, but it also just secures the tenants.
Okay.
So, I mean, like, it's changed things. Like, a lot of people don't know that you can actually, it's illegal to say you can't have a pet.
Mm-hmm. It's illegal to say you can't have a pet?
It's a human right.
Can't be written in.
Because
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Unless they can prove, though, that the landlord is allergic or it is a, you know, it is a scary animal that might cause harm to the neighbors.
But like other than that. Safety issue.
Yeah, but you can't just say no to a pet just for the sake of it.
So
but
you could challenge the landlord?
You can, for sure.
Okay.
But it's a difficult task because if you put it on, They may not say that's the reason they're not giving you the place,
right.
But it's got depending on who your landlord is, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. What other sorts of things can we do to protect ourselves based on the legislation?
Well, I mean, it's always good to use a professional, I always say, right? I mean, they can always do background checks as well. I mean, it's always important to know who your landlord is and have a good relationship. A lot of times than not, we are seeing that there are a lot of overseas landlords. So it is good to have a relationship with the other realtor, because sometimes they act as the landlord here for them.
So millennials watching right now, they're looking for a place. When is the best time to try and secure one, and should they rent or buy?
I always tell people if they're looking to move, don't, because you're not going to find something as cheap as you have it today. Yeah. If you're able to buy, this is the time to do it, because we are experiencing a market where there is a decent amount of inventory at prices that aren't going beyond hundreds of thousands of dollars from the initial ask price.
Okay. Great tips.
Jonathan,
thank you so
thank
much.
You
thank you very much.
For more information, where do we find you?
You can find me on Instagram at Jonathan Orlando Real Estate, or through the Blue Elephant Realty website at www.blueelephantrealty.com.
Thank you.
Right,
thank
great
you,
tips.
More coming up after the break.
It's crazy now.